Good morning, students. Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
So last class we have seen about parallel shifter operations. So according to parallel shifter component, your ARM Cortex M4 processor has the ability to perform 32-bit shift and rotate operations. Okay. So, did you complete that homework problem? Have you all completed?
Yes, ma'am.
This is the problem I gave. So, what is the answer for first one? So, first instruction, move R2 comma hash 0x20, which is equivalent to 512 decimal. Okay. So, we are going to rotate this number 6 times towards left direction. Okay. So, after execution of this instruction, so what is the answer? So, what is the answer after execution? So you are going to perform logical shift left, okay? So multiply the register content by 2 power 6, okay? So which is equal to 512 into 2 power 6. So what is the answer? What is the answer? 0800.
8000.
So, see, there is a one online calculator to perform all the operation, the 32-bit number. Just all of you. It was very low here. One second. Open this website. So using this calculator, we can perform all the operation. That is logical shift, arithmetic shift, circular, right, rotate through carry. Are you able to see screen?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So here, just you enter the value first, your input value. It can be a hexadecimal number or decimal number. And you should specify the size of the input. So we are handling 32-bit number. So just you enter 32-bit. And number of time shift operation to be performed, you should enter here. Okay. And this is the symbol for left shift. And this is the symbol for shift right. Okay. So just you enter the number and find out the answer. So first, logical shift left, okay? So perform the, just you click this perform bit shift operation. So this is going to be your answer. It's 8000. All of you getting this manually?
Yes, ma'am.
Students, just you cross-check your answer using this calculator, because it's a 32-bit rotation and shift operation is very difficult to do. Very difficult to, it's a complex operation. So you can check your answer using this calculator. So next operation, logical shift right. So just you press this one and perform the operation. So your answer is 8. All of you getting this? 8?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So just look at the, this is your input. This one specifies number of shifts to be performed. And based on the logical, that shift operation, the bits are shifted towards right direction. Okay. And that is your bits are inserted, that zeros are inserted at the right direction and shifted towards right direction. So first, the one is in this place, next rotation, it is moved into this position. Next here, likewise. So the final thing, after the sixth shift operation, you will be getting this answer, 8. Okay. So what is the next one? Arithmetic shift. Okay. Just you click this. Okay. So the operation is, it will preserve the assigned magnitude and remaining bits are shifted towards right direction. Okay. So perform the operation. So what is the answer?
8.
Is that correct? So this number is a positive number or negative number?
Positive number.
Positive number. Okay. All of you getting this answer?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, okay. And next one is the rotate right through carry. So this is equivalent to your R O R. Okay. So check your answer. What is the answer for R O R? Students, you should interact. This is the homework problem. You have to tell me the answer. What is the answer?
8.
Okay. So next one is the circular shift. Once again, rotate through carry is similar to ROR. Okay, your carry is seen. See, just to check this slide. ROR, the last bit is placed in carry and remaining bits are towards right direction. So this is something different. Okay. So what is the answer for your rotate right extended? Rotate right extended.
100.
So put your answer.
100.
Answer in the chat box. Are you getting this? Yes. So what is the answer for ROR? Just put it in the chat box for ROR. So what is the answer for ROR? Okay. See, for a logical shift left, your answer is 8000. Okay. Logical shift right, your answer is 8. Arithmetic shift right, your answer is 8. Okay. And rotate right, that is ROR 8. Okay. Rotate right extended, your answer is, what is the answer? 100. Okay. Have all of you noted?
Yes, ma'am.
So this is the example slide, just you can go through. Already you are aware of this one. So logical shift left by 4 is equivalent to shift left in C. So 4 means the 4 bits are shifted towards left direction and 4 zeros are inserted at the LSB of the word. Okay. And logical shift right by 4 means 4 zeros are inserted at the rightmost end of the word. Remaining bits are shifted towards right direction. So this is equivalent to logical shift right in C. It will perform unsigned division by a power of 2. Okay. And arithmetic shift right by 4. So this is for positive value and this is for negative value. Okay. If the value is positive, so for 4 rotation, the 4 shift operation, 4 zeros are preserved here. In the MSB bits, okay, 4 zeros are preserved and remaining bits are shifted towards right direction. Okay. For negative value, so here arithmetic shift right by 4. 4 ones are preserved at the MSB bits and remaining bits are shifted towards right direction. Okay. So this is rotate right by 4. Okay. So the first 4 bits, LSB bits, are placed in the MSB and remaining bits are shifted towards right direction. And rotate right extended, carry is placed in 31st bit and your 0 bit is placed in carry and remaining bits are rotated towards right direction. So it will perform 32 bit complete rotation through carry bit. Okay. So these are some of the example instruction, that is parallel shift instruction. So what is the first one? Please tell me. One second. Slide is not changing. Just look at the first instruction. Move R0, LSL hash 1. So what is the operation of this particular instruction? What is the operation? Shift left, okay. So this component is called a parallel shifter component. That is R0, LSL hash 1. So this operand is called an operand. Okay. So it is going to multiply the R0 content by 2 power 1. Yeah. What is that now? Yes. Am I audible?
Move R0, comma R0.
One second, ma'am. Yes. One second. I'll switch over the scan Wi-Fi. See, first instruction, move R0, LSL hash 1. Okay. So multiply the R0 by 2 power 1. Okay. So this is your source operand. R0, LSL hash 1 is the source operand. And this is called operand N. So your ARM processor decodes the instruction like this. Move R0, N. So the N is directly given to your parallel shifter. Is it clear, students? Is that clear? Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
So your R naught is multiplied by 2 power 1. Okay. After that, the result will be folded by this n operand. Okay. And after performing the operation, this n value is moved into R naught. For example, if R naught content is 2, 2 into 2 power 1 is 4. After execution, this R naught holds 4. Is that clear? Say something. Is that clear?
Yes,
ma'am. Okay. What is the next instruction? Move R1, LSR hash 2. So divide R1 by 2 power 2. So that is the operation. Divide R1 by 2 power 2. And next one is the signed one, that is arithmetic shift right operation. So divide R2 by 2 power 2. Is that clear? And next, move R3, ROR hash 16. So this instruction is going to rotate the content of R3 16 times towards right direction. After rotation, the result will be folded by R3. Is that clear, students? So this is going to perform the operation, that is swapping operation. Swap the LSB and MSB. Since the 16 rotations, that is 16 rotation is carried out, so your LSB and MSB values are swapped. So what is the next one? Add R4, LSL hash 4. So which operand is a source operand and which operand is a destination operand here? So which one is
R3 and R6?
So which one is source operand?
R4, LSL hash 4.
What about again R4 is mentioned here? See,
that is like R and
M. Yes, actually this instruction is going to perform two operations. One is the multiply operation, that is multiplication operation, and another one is the add operation. Okay, so according to this instruction, actually add R4, LSL hash 4. Okay. So this is going to be your destination operand. Remaining all will be source operand. So at the end of the execution, your R4 holds the result. So first it will perform multiplication of operation by using these two operands. So your R4 content is multiplied by 2 power 4. Is that clear, students? Is that clear? Okay. So what is the next operation after performing shift?
Addition.
Addition. So one second, I will write it in the board and explain. So your instruction is add R4, 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 LSL#4. So first it will carry out this operation. Next it is going to perform R4 with this N operator, perform addition operation. So the first step, R4 is multiplied by 2^4. So after multiplication, the result will be stored in N. Okay, and second step, according to the instruction, one more operand is included here. So the operation is addition, next operation. So R4 is equal to R4 plus N. So the R4 content is added with this parallel shift operand. After that, the result will be holded by R4. Is that clear, students? So the single instruction can perform both multiplication and addition. Is it clear or not?
Clear.
Okay. First, it will perform logical shift left instruction. So multiply the register content by 2^4, and that result will be holded by N operand. Okay. After that, the main opcode is here, add. Okay, after a shift operation, we are going to add the content of N with R4. Once the addition process is over, result is updated in R4 register. So look at this example. So R4 is shifted towards left direction 4 times. After the operation, the result will be added with R4, and after the addition, the entire result will be holded by R4 register. Is that clear? And next one is the reverse subtraction along with parallel shift operand. Okay, it is RSB, reverse subtract. R5, 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 LSL#4. So what is the first operation? It is the first operation to be performed.
Multiply the content of R5 with 2^5.
Multiply the content by 2^5. Okay. So this is the first operation. So multiply the register content, R5 content, by 2^5. So after that, this R5 value is subtracted from this value. So reverse subtraction means generally normal subtraction subtract R1, R2, R3. So normally what it will do is subtract the R3 content from R2. R2 minus R3, and result will be holded by R1. Okay. Suppose in the case of reverse subtraction, R1, R2, R3. Okay. So the operation is R3 minus R2. The second operand is subtracted from third operand. Okay. So normal subtraction, what it will do, the third operand is subtracted from the second operand. So that is the difference. Is that clear, students?
Yes,
ma'am.
So in general subtract operation, your third operand is subtracted from the second operand. So this is your R2 is going to be a second operand and R3 is going to be a third operand. In reverse subtraction operation, the second operand is subtracted from third operand. So in this example, it is going to perform reverse subtraction. So after this, okay, so this your third operand is subtracted from the second one. It is R5 multiplied by 2^5 minus R. Is that clear, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
See, first look at the first example and observe the result. So what do you infer from this?
Ma'am, not audible, ma'am.
Actually, look at the first example. Ramba break aagudha pa voice sir.
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
ma'am.
In the slide open pannadhula irundhu onnu kekkalam.
Seri. So idhula paarenga, first you look at the first example and observe the operation and tell me your inference. See, generally in multiplication instruction, what your ARM processor will do is just it will multiply the register content by a constant. Okay, so loading a constant into your register means during the execution it will take more number of internal clock cycle in order to complete its execution. Okay, instead of that we can perform the multiplication instruction, okay, by combining addition operation. Okay, so that can be performed by using LSL along with your add instruction. So we can perform the multiplication by combining simple instructions like addition with your parallel shift operation. Okay, so just you look at this example. The example given here is we have to multiply R1 content by 5. So it's a simple multiply operation, but it requires more number of clock cycle. Okay, so in order to reduce the number of clock cycle, so our ARM architecture has a provision of including add instruction to perform multiply operation. Okay, so the instruction is add R0 comma R1 comma R1 comma LSL hash 2. So the given operation is we have to multiply the register content by 5. Okay, instead of multiplying the register content by a constant, okay, we can do the operation by combining addition and shift operation. Okay, so R1 plus R1 into 4. So this expression can be written as R1 plus R1 into 4. Okay, so first what I am going to do is, first I am going to shift this register content, that is multiply this register content by 2 power 2. Okay, so let's assume your R1 holds 2. So according to this expression, your answer will be 2 into 5 10. Okay, so first we have to complete this one, next add the answer with this register content. Finally, you have to load that value into R2 register. Okay, so let's assume your R1 holds 2. Okay, so first 2 into 2 power 2. What is the answer?
8.
8. So for this, you got 8. So what is the R1 content? What is R1 content?
2.
2. So what will be the answer?
10.
10. So this is moved to which register? R. So instead of multiplying the register content by numeric constant, we can perform the multiplication operation by combining simple operations like additions and logical shift operation. So this takes less number of instructions. So the entire operation, that is entire instruction, will perform multiplication operation. Let us multiply the register content by numeric constant. Is it clear, students?
Yes, ma'am.
So multiplication can be replaced by combining addition with logical shift left. That's all. Okay. So look at the second example. So we are going to perform this one. Multiply R3 content by 105. Okay, so this can be written as R3 into 15 into 7. Okay, and this 15 can be written as 16 minus 1, and the 7 can be written as 8 minus 1. Okay. To perform this operation, we need to incorporate these two reverse subtract instructions. So what do you infer from this? So tell me the step-by-step operation. So you have to multiply R3 content by 105, okay? So that can be written as 15 into 7. 105 can be written as 15 into 7. So for simplicity, for calculating 2 power n, we can write 15 as 16 minus 1 and 7 as 8 minus 1 so that we can calculate 2 power n, okay? So for that, 16 minus 1, 8 minus 1. So what is the first instruction? Reverse subtract R2 comma R3 comma R3 comma LSL hash 4. So this will perform the R3 register content. Let's multiply R3 register content by 15. And this will perform the content of multiply R2 content by 7. How it will perform, please tell. Are you able to follow? Students, are you able to follow?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So what is the operation of first instruction, RSB instruction? Please tell me.
First, R3 is multiplied by 2 power 4.
Yes, very good.
And then it will be stored in R3 and then it will reverse subtracted.
Okay, reverse subtracted from which register? R3 register.
Minus
okay. R2. Okay. So what is the answer? So let's assume your R3 holds 2. Find out the answer. Let's assume your R3 holds 2. So your operation is R2 is equal to R3 into 105. Okay. So this can be written as R3 into 15 into 7. And this can be written as 15 can be replaced by 16 minus 1 into 8 minus 1. Okay. So what is the first instruction? RSB R2 comma R3 comma R3 comma LSL hash 4. Okay, so let's assume your R3 holds 2. Find out the answer first. So 2 into 105, you have to get, you are supposed to get 210. Okay, so what is the answer for first RSB instruction?
13.
Actually, R3 holds, so 2 into 2 power 4, what is the answer? 2 power 4 is 16. 16 into 2, your answer is
32.
So, according to this operand, you will be getting 32. Okay. After that, we have to perform reverse subtraction. So, 32 minus R3. So what is the answer? What is the answer? 30. So after execution, of this instruction, your R2 holds 30. Okay. So just you look at the slide. So this instruction going to perform, it is going to multiply R3 by 15. So 15 into 2, what is the answer? 30. So you are able to get this 30. So what is the next instruction? So next instruction is RSB R2, LSL hash 3. So find out the answer. So according to the previous instruction, we got 30. Your R2 holds 30. Okay, here your R2 holds 30. So perform the logical shift left and find out the answer.
R2 will contain 210.
Okay. So 30 into 2 power 3. What is the answer?
240.
So this operand holds 240. And R2 holds, subtract this value. Subtract R2 from 240. So R2 holds 30. What is the answer now?
210.
So after execution, your R2 holds 210. So what is the given expression? Your R2 is equal to R3 into 105. Your input is 2. So 2 into 105, 210. So using these two instructions, we can achieve, that is, we can able to get this 210 answer. So these two instructions simply performs multiply operation by incorporating reverse subtract instruction and logical shift left instruction. Is that clear, students?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
You have any doubts regarding this?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
See, to perform 32-bit multiplication, it takes several number of clock cycles. In order to reduce the clock cycle, to implement multiplication operation by combining addition or subtraction instruction along with logical shift operation. So that is the objective of your parallel shifter component in ARM Cortex M4 process. So here, this multiplication expression can be implemented by combining addition instruction and LSL instruction. Okay, and for this operation, that is multiply the register content R3 by 105, can be implemented by executing two RSB instruction along with logical shift left instruction. So next class we will see about your pipelining structure of ARM Cortex M3 and M4 process. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.